putting most involved with this, Kansas and Adidas school. But Chris, the biggest thing, I don't need to talk about any other coach, any other school. You brought up Bill Self. I'm glad you did. That's the one. Because to me, look, follow the recruitment of Cliff Alexander. And then tell me again. There's a reason his nickname's Dollar Bill. Now, D'Souza was caught up in this deal, allegedly, right? Now, D'Souza's got to sit. You got Self going up there going, up. Oh, hey, whoa, our players got paid, but we didn't know. But yeah, please.
Who's
got
to sit, Mike? The kid.
Right.
And there's Bill Self walking around. I didn't know nothing. I get paid. I don't know nothing. Yes, this is the problem.
I'm with you.
Saying?
And look.
And I didn't hear any outrage on the broadcast last night of, all I heard was on the Blue Blood program they got all these players coming back. They're a top five team. They could go to the Final Four.
I didn't hear one thing
about the outrage of.
It was early, they talked about it.
FBI investigation.
Well, Vitale, that old fool, he got up there. We need to get the cheaters out of the game. Hey, Dick, the guy's right in front of you. All right, one of those cheaters you want to get out of the game, he's standing right in front of you, Dick. That's all I know. I don't know about Bill Self and his program. I just know the cheater. You shut up with this ham and eggs routine, Dick. You know. You're Dick Vitale, for God's sakes. You know. You know everything that's going on in front of your face. Don't play dumb. You know. But you like hamming it up with these coaches too much, to be honest. I can't speak on this. I just don't. Shut up. Bill Self's the one I want. That's who I want gone. I don't have a stronger feeling. Every bone in my body believes Bill Self's a cheat. Follow certain recruitments. Connect the dots on it. He's the one I want. I may dislike other coaches more. Bill Self's the one I want to see go down. Now I got to see Dick Vitale sitting right in front of Dick, right in front of Bill Self. I don't know. I just hope they do right by the school. Oh my God. Can we put Vitale out the pasture? Or is that wrong of me to say that? Where it's like, I just don't want to see him do games anymore. I can't handle it. It was such a better broadcast when Jay Billis took over for Duke Kentucky in the nightcap.
It's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Let's get this blitz next, 97.1.
Well, if you want to learn the most, get the most out of your home, learn the most accurate home value, download the YouPraise app in the App Store today. It's a newer app. It was designed by realtors, top realtors across the country, and it is statistically the most accurate value for your home. 8 times more accurate than Zillow and all the other sites. It's worth it to at least download the app, sign on, and see what your home's worth. See what your home's worth. It's going to be the most accurate value for your home. And the cool thing is, once you're in the YouPraise app, you can upload pictures. You can increase the value of your home. You don't have to log on to Zillow or log on to one of the other sites and see a home value that you don't think is anywhere near the correct value for your home. With YouPraise, you're getting the statistically most accurate value for your home. And then you upload the pictures. Maybe you did a renovation. Maybe you made some upgrades to your home. You can upload pictures, get immediate value increase. You can increase the real value for your home based on the pictures and the upgrades that you've done. You choose YouPraise. You get a home estimate in seconds, a confidential certified YouPraisal. It's worth it to download it in the App Store today. YouPraise, U-P-R-A-Z-E. Go download it, punch in your address, and you're going to get the most accurate value for your home. YouPraise, U-P-R-A-Z-E.
97.1, the ticket.
This report brought to you by Mastercraft Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Before you turn on your furnace this fall, call Mastercraft Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Fast service and installation for over 35 years. Go to MastercraftHeating.com. That's MastercraftHeating.com. In Ann Arbor, M14 eastbound, the exit ramp to Barton Drive, closed right now due to a crash. 75 both directions between Adams and 12 Mile, the ongoing work zone, left lane closure with backups in both directions. Your Nissan Intelligent Mobility alternate route is to Stevenson Highway. Traffic also brought to you by Nissan Intelligent Mobility. Nissan Intelligent Mobility is tech that's changing the way you drive forever. But no matter how much technology they put in their cars, they'll always keep you in the driver's seat. Learn more about Nissan Intelligent Mobility at NissanUSA.com. I'm Michelle Pena on the WWJ 24-Hour Traffic Center.
true showstopper is the Ram 1500, named one of Ward's 10 best interiors. Nor will any holiday errand be too much to handle, thanks to Ram 1500's best-in-class V8 towing and the available Hemi V8 engine. And with Ram 3500's best-in-class fifth-wheel towing, we'll give old St. Nick's sled a run for its money. Hurry in for a great deal at the Ram Black Friday sales event. Well-qualified returning FCA employee lessees get a low-mileage lease on the all-new 2019 Ram 1500 Bighorn Crew Cab 4x4 with a V6 engine for $179 a month for 24 months with $2,841 due at signing. Tax, title, license, extra. Class based on light-duty pickups and 350, 3500 pickups when properly equipped. Properly secure all cargo. Always towed within the vehicle's capacity. Call 1-877-RAM-5722 for details. Requires daily contribution at least through U.S. Bank. Lessee is solely responsible for termination fees. Current lease must end by 12/2/19. 25-cent charge for each mile over 20,000. Residency restrictions apply. Take delivery by 12/3/18.
Okay, thermostat at 68. Cozy sweater, warm socks, check.
You meet Andy. He's an expert at saving on his heating bill because he went to dteenergy.com/saveenergy.
Blinds open to the sun, rugs off the vents, check.
Andy uses all of DTE's no-cost tips for staying warm while saving money.
Football game on, warm blanket, and now time for a snuggle with my sweetie. Come here, sweetie.
Stay warm, save money. DTE Energy. Know your own power. Want more money in the bank? Save on your DTE Energy bill.
Save money? How?
For winter, seal air leaks and add insulation to make your heating system up to 20% more efficient.
Joe, come here, listen to this.
Replace incandescents with Energy Star lighting and save big. They use up to 90% less energy.
I want to know more.
Find out more at dteenergy.com/saveenergy.
Joe, get the computer.
DTE Energy. Know your own power.
The car guys know not all motor oils are created equal. Because when your engine hits 75,000 miles, cheaper motor oils won't do. That's why Valvoline created full synthetic high mileage with Max Light technology, designed to fight sludge, condition seals, and better protect critical engine components as your engine ages. Keep your high mileage ride driving well into the future. Valvoline. Trust them for 150 years. Now in Advanced Auto Parts, buy 5 quarts of Valvoline full synthetic high mileage in a filter for just $33.99. Terms and conditions may apply.
This hour of the Mike Valenti Show is brought to you by Capital Mortgage Funding. Call 1-800-LOW-RATE.
Imagining a better bank starts with looking at the savings rates most banks offer and saying, really? Capital One is building something better. You can open a Capital One savings account with one of the nation's best savings rates from anywhere, like here, or here, or here. One of the nation's best savings rates. Opened online, at a Capital One location, or from anywhere. That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
For consumers only. Offered by Capital One N.A. member FDIC. Copyright 2018 Capital One.
If you have frequent heartburn, take control of it with Prilosec OTC. Instead of stashing antacids everywhere, like in your junk drawer, buried under old batteries and hotel pens, or in your purse, hiding in the one pocket you won't check. You even have antacids on your nightstand, which are very hard to see in the dark. It's time you stopped stashing antacids and started taking Prilosec OTC. One pill a day, 24 hours, zero heartburn.
It's possible with Prilosec OTC. Uses directed for 14 days, not for immediate relief.
Sports news all day, every day. This is 97.1 The Ticket.
Brought to you by your Southeast Michigan Ford dealers. Lions back on the field today, turning their attention to Sunday's game with the Bears. They were missing TJ Lang and Darius Slay. We'll also run the NFL. Dez Bryant found a new home, agreeing to terms on a 1-year deal with the Saints. Well, former Lions running back Amir Abdullah has found a new team, staying in the division, signing out with the Minnesota Vikings. The Pistons looking to get back on track tonight. The Ticket on the Magic down in Orlando. We'll have it for you right here on the Ticket at 6:35. Ryan Woolley, more at 6 or at 97.1theticket.com. All right, Mikey, let's get a blitz in the mix. We have been so myopic with the Lions. There's so many things that went on this weekend. Let's go. Let's get this blitz in the mix.
We have time for one more. All right, might as well. Why does it always seem like wide receivers are the biggest divas?
Pants, the soaks.
Nice job on the blitz, Mike.
All right, question one. Got to start out with the news of the day. Dez Bryant signing with the Saints. Your thoughts on that? How much does it help New Orleans to have him there?
I mean, it gives him a red zone target. That's all I think Dez is. But I think it's way more sizzle than steak. But, yeah, I mean, a guy who 10-yard line and in, big body, I'm fine with it. the snaps and have a big role. That would surprise me.
Troy Aikman said the Cowboys need a complete overhaul of the entire organization. Very, very critical of the Cowboys. Do you agree with Aikman on that?
Yes. I'm stunned he said it because it's the equivalent of going against the family. But, yeah, he's right. I mean, Jerry Jones wields too much power. Jason Garrett has been there way too long. There's too much noise. There's too much distraction. The whole thing needs to be gutted. But I don't think it'll happen. But I'm proud of Troy Aikman for saying it. Again, it's like we've talked about the Dan Orlovsky comments with Stafford. Guess what? That's Aikman's team. That's Aikman's family. But he was still honest about it. So I'll listen to him. I like it.
Fury touchdown. As the deadline nears, Le'Veon Bell Steelers still not in contact. The deadline to report next Tuesday at 4 p.m. Over this next less than a week, how do you see this shaping out? Do you think he does ultimately report?
I think he reports on Tuesday. I think he'll report at the deadline. I think it's pretty clear what he's doing. I mean, he left Miami. Then he's at an L.A. Fitness or Lifetime Fitness playing basketball. I mean, the guy, I don't know what's going on, but he's got to report. He'll report Tuesday. David, you're our resident Steeler expert. He'll report Tuesday.
Yeah, he'll report Tuesday, but I'm so sick and tired of every report saying, well, he has no contact with the team yet. Who cares? He'll report when he reports.
And the Steelers will play him.
Yes, they will.
You're fooling yourself if you think they're going to bench him and it's going to be James Conner. Come on, as good as Conner's been, he's not Le'Veon Bell. Next.
Atlanta Falcons, 4-4 after a 1-4 start. Started 1-4, we know the percentages, the nominal chance you have to make the playoffs, but sitting there at 4-4 Atlanta, their division, what do you view their playoff chances at right now?
Zero.
You don't think they have any chance to make it?
No, I mean, Keon Neal and Christian Jones, and they lost so many high-level defensive players for the season. Not going to get all excited because they won a few games over a couple overrated teams. So, Mike, I think they'll be exciting. They might screw up somebody else's season. But to go from 1-4 to 9-7, I don't think they got the defense to even come close. So I'll still say none.
Our next category here in the Blitz. Kind of stuff.
Why do you say Christian Jones? It's Deion Jones.
Deion Jones,
I'm sorry about that, guys.
Stuff we've learned at the midseason point.
What is wrong with me?
These are all somewhat of hot takes. Tell me if you agree with these.
Sure.
Andy Reid's quarterback plan, meaning moving from Alex Smith to Pat Mahomes, give Mahomes a year, put him in there. Andy Reid's quarterback plan was the genius move of the past 2 years in the NFL.
I think the genius move would have to be drafting the quarterback while you have Alex Smith. But, yeah, if you want to go that way, that's fine. That works, too. And it's probably the most preferable way to bring a new quarterback into your system and to transition out versus doing what these teams are doing now, like Buffalo, that are just throwing Josh Allen to the Wolves.
ESPN had a list of some of the midseason stuff. Best three quarterbacks of the first half of the season. Tell me if you agree with this. If you disagree, then give your answer for it. Best three quarterbacks of the first half, Pat Mahomes, Drew Brees, Ryan Fitzpatrick.
No, disagree. That's ridiculous. Cam Newton should be there. Jared Goff could make a case to be there. No, it's wholly ridiculous with Fitzmagic. It's outrageous.
Who would you put there instead, though?
I mean, flip a coin. You want Cam there, I could accept it. But I really think the one they left out was Jared Goff. And Jared Goff's had a great first half. Coming off maybe the game of his career in New Orleans.
There's a big article on ESPN today about something the Panthers did in terms of how this changes the landscape of football. They hired a mental health clinical person to be at their facility full-time. They called this a game changer because of all the issues with mental health, the NFL, and other sports and stuff like that. Do you see this trend only continuing with the importance of mental health in sports, in facilities?
What the hell am I supposed to know?
It was one of the biggest news.
What kind of question it is? I don't know. Yes?
It's never been done before. No team's ever hired a mental health
I know, but position. I sure. Okay, yes. I mean, it's a good idea, I suppose. I don't know if it's going to be a trend. I don't even know what the person does.
It's a huge topic in the world of sports right now.
Is it?
Oh, it's talked about all the time in the NBA and NFL.
No, I'm saying this new position that's been created. I don't even know what the job duties are. Are Are they licensed?
Anxiety, mental illness.
Can they prescribe medication? Are they just giving the general counsel?
Prevalence of depression, prevalence of anxiety, all that type of stuff.
I'm just going to tell you, you normally do a good job. This question, awful.
It's one of the biggest themes in sports.
Well, give me more details. I think David, he's shaking his head. David, you agree. This is not a good blitz question. If you didn't give me enough details.
If you guys don't value the importance of mental health, that's fine. I'll move on.
You piece of garbage.
All right, next question.
Wow.
Another bold statement here. Tell me if you think it's accurate. Matt Nagy has been the coach of the year so far in the NFL.
No.
It was another one on ESPN's.
He blew the Green Bay game because he had tight booty hole syndrome once he got up 17. And he blew the Miami game when he settled and played for a 53-yard field goal on the road. How the hell could he be coach of the year?
I think probably with the low expectations for Chicago.
You're terrible, and that article's terrible.
That's not my words. That's something I saw online.
David and I are still upset at that last question where we were given no details and got hung out to dry.
I told you it's a bold take.
This is David. What is happening?
Everything's fine. Another bold take here.
Sully's trivia night is sold out.
The Ravens should start Lamar Jackson. They're rolling with Joe Flacco, but they should transition to Lamar Jackson.
No. What they need to do is, if they're going to put Lamar Jackson in the game, let him throw the ball once. The Wildcat and all your stupid games don't work if there's no threat of a quarterback throwing. They haven't let him throw the ball. I think by December 7th, you'd look at getting Lamar a few starts. But right now, they're still in the mix. No, I would not start Lamar Jackson. Who made these questions?
Who would you label right now as midseason MVP?
Eli Manning. Because if we go 1-15, we get the number one pick. That's my MVP. No, the MVP, I think Drew Brees has a hell of a case. Pat Mahomes is probably going to run away with it. I'll just give you another option. Mahomes, to me, he's been truly remarkable.
Save the boldest, craziest one for last.
Oh, you mean the questions get worse as we go on?
These have been all very, very relevant questions. Boldest, craziest for last.
All right.
This is another one on ESPN's midseason report card, whatever you want to call it. Should the Colts consider shutting down Andrew Luck? Now, that might sound silly, but the reasoning, considering his rebuilt shoulder, the Colts' playoff chances, and the potential to showcase Jacoby Brissett as offseason trade bait, at what point this season should the Colts consider shutting down Andrew Luck?
Pull up the Colts schedule.
The 3-5
right now. Yeah, exactly. But I think they've got a soft schedule, and they actually have a hope of making the playoffs. You can't shut them down November 7th. Now, if you're 4-7, 5-9, you want to shut them down the last few weeks, I'm okay with that. But, Mike, I think they got a little shot here. Who do they got this week?
Jaguars, Titans, Dolphins, Jaguars again.
Yeah, they can win the next four.
Texans, Cowboys, Giants.
Okay, so there's one game on there that I guarantee you they don't win. And even that team they almost beat, but they went for it in overtime and lost. No, I'd let it play. I'd play it out as trenches to do what it takes to get the job done. So who was the best offensive line in the NFL last week? Who made the toughest plays? Who was worthy of the honor of being named the Built for Tough Offensive Line of the Week? It was the Atlanta Falcons. Go to NFL.com/Ford for Sean O'Hara's commentary on how the Falcons raised the bar. The Ford F-150 doesn't just raise the bar, it is the bar.
There are three things every homeowner wants their home to be: smarter, safer, and more fun. What if I told you you could do all three in one product? Introducing the OneLink Safe and Sound, a hardwired smart smoke and carbon monoxide alarm with a premium home speaker and Amazon Alexa voice assistant in one sleek device. Built with First Alert safety technology and providing an immersive, great sound experience, the Safe and Sound elevates any home. Learn more at onelink.firstalert.com. That's onelink.firstalert.com.
DTE Energy has some good news about your bill. We're passing along our corporate tax savings to you and reducing your electric rates by 3%. And that's on top of the fact that we've maintained the cost of electricity while other living expenses have continued to increase. At DTE, we're always working hard to ensure fair prices and help you manage monthly costs. So when we save, you save too. DTE Energy. While you're living your life, DTE Energy is keeping energy flowing to help you do it. We're building a smarter energy grid for the future, upgrading systems and installing sensors to detect and isolate outages so fewer customers are affected. That means safer, more reliable energy, so you can have peace of mind and a lot more fun.
I won! Woohoo!
DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Look, it's not that complicated. Instead of trying to sell somebody something, I just listen to what people need. And then I craft my service around them. It's not what people expect from a bank, but I think it's what they deserve. Flagstar Bank. What solutions can we craft for you? Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
97.1 The Ticket and CBS Sports Radio 1270. Your homes for the NFL on Westwood One. The Pittsburgh Steelers host the Carolina Panthers. Thursday Night Football. Pre-game at 8 on CBS Sports Radio 1270.
Against Bama. A fight has ensued. Jimmy Powers has suspended Bob for overt homerism. Evan was party to this. It is remarkable as Wojo is now yelling at Bogey about Michigan's chances versus the Crimson Tide. Mike Valeni reporting, WWJ. There's no saving him, Sully. None. And Evan was there for it. And Bogey was there, and Powers was there. There's no saving that guy.
When I see Alabama, I just see a team that's on a whole other level. Significantly.
Like, LSU's running game is beastly. How'd that look against Bama? What, you think Michigan would do a whole lot better? What, are you kidding me? They had negative rushing yards. Now, listen, Patterson's better than Joe Burrow, there's no doubt. But remember, Alabama went to Death Valley at night and did what they did. That ain't a neutral site. There's no helping one. None.
He loves his Michigan.
He does.
M. Go Bob.
Atta, baby. Hey, listen. You know what? The guy deserves it. He's had to begrudgingly go to Indianapolis three times to cover Michigan State, rooting against them, not even enjoying his meal at St. Elmo's. At least now, him and the Go Blue Brigade get to go down there and enjoy themselves. It'd be like a college reunion.
But why can't he just admit it to us? Why can't he just admit it and say, yeah, I'd like to see Michigan go to the playoff?
Because Wojo's got a problem. Like, he doesn't want to make Michigan fan angry. He wants to be loved by everybody. So it is what, oh, I'm sorry. Bob, I didn't know you were standing.
What?
No, I let everybody know what you were uttering out. since he's got like a Celine Dion record playing. I try to be respectful.
I'll stand by you.
You guys are unfair.
I'll stand.
You gave the city everything, you sons of bitches.
Oh, no.
Yeah, how could you do Danny-O like that?
How did you just do yourself like that out there?
What is this, Mojo's intro music?
Yeah.
Hey, wow, what's happening?
What?
And now, weighing in at 550 pounds.
You guys are hilarious.
That's
because you
nice.
Paint me a certain way, even though I've been right every step of the way this season. Every single step of the way.
Except for Notre Dame.
I believe this.
Except for Notre Dame, which everybody
And they're not winning because of Shea Patterson. Shea Patterson's doing enough for them to win.
I said he has been a difference.
You said he was winning the Heisman. That's just not happening.
Did not.
You did.
Let's see. I remember a month ago I said, Bogey said, you don't think they have a shot against Wisconsin, Penn State, or Ohio State, do you? I said, of course they do. If you watch their defense,
you know what's funny?
Then he did this. This is what he did.
That was immediately following Notre Dame. They looked like a trash team.
After.
Okay, maybe SMU when they were flirting with Southern Methodist. Sorry.
So because I've been correct, you guys are trying to exaggerate.
Okay, let me ask you this
question.
Yes.
What radio show said they would murder Wisconsin, that Wisconsin's a fraud?
Wisconsin's a good team.
Oh, that's me.
Fine.
And who said 38-13 along with you against Penn State?
Me.
And me.
No.
So leave me out of that, Jack.
No, I'm bringing him into it. Bogey.
That's fine.
That's your boy.
I know.
And look, I've been wrong
distance
about Michigan.
Tonight,
they're going to get
live chat with nobody.
Well, I certainly haven't been wrong about that. By the way, how exciting would it be to be a Hawks fan? You got Trae Young balling, and you got Zion Williamson probably on his way. How much fun is that going to be? Meanwhile, Pistons at Amway Arena down in Orlando tonight. Should be exciting. Let me ask you this, though. I saw some future lines.
Hey, give me those future lines.
Okay.
Those are really interesting.
Bovada official future lines, college football playoff neutral field, okay? Mm-hmm. If Notre Dame is to meet Alabama, Notre Dame plus 21.
Whoa.
If Clemson is to meet Alabama, Clemson plus 9. If Michigan is to meet Alabama, plus 14.5. Are you taking Michigan in the points right here, right now? Be honest.
Okay. Notre Dame beat Michigan, and they're better than Michigan.
This is in perspective how they match up with them.
Why are they getting? But then why does
now
Michigan?
Ask you a question.
Why is Michigan considered?
Are you
a
taking Michigan to the points?
I would take the points, 14.5. I've heard that laugh.
It was just 14.5 with LSU at LSU, and they beat him by 30.
I heard that laugh before when I tried to explain to him that Penn State, Wisconsin,
we'll go
what's funny is Rojo hates straw man arguments, but now he is the straw man.